Demi Lovato is secretly dating John Mayer.
Justin calls himself an asshole and storms off stage.
And Taylor Swift claps back at Calvin performing This Is What You Came For.
All that and more on today's rundown. All right, if you came for some nip slips, we have that for you later on in the show.
That is what you came for. We're gonna bring it to you. But first, let's talk about Demi Lovato secretly dating John Mayer.
What?
I guarantee you, if you look up the most unlikely couple in the dictionary, I don't know if they have like phrases in the dictionary, but if they did, it would have Demi Lovato and John Mayer's face next to that phrase. Yeah. But you guys, that might be something that's actually happening. So Demi and John, they were spotted hanging out at Catch LA, which is like an LA rooftop restaurant, on Saturday night. And according to Us Weekly, they arrived separately, but a source said, quote, John had his arm around Demi and was whispering sweet nothings into her ear. Demi was, quote, into it and was seen giggling the whole time. John also reportedly praised Demi for having, quote, one of the greatest voices. Now, there is no photo evidence of this happening. This is just a source. But, you know, I think there is a possibility. They could be dating, of course. I mean, anyone could be dating in Hollywood, right? But I think that she's talked about in the past how he is kind of an inspiration for her music. And I think that maybe there's like some sort of collaboration that could happen from this versus like a dating thing. Because he's significantly older. He's 39 and she's 24.
Yeah.
And she was most recently seen with that boxer guy who is so the opposite of John Mayer. Big, buff, strong. John Mayer is like this like artsy indie hippie kind of guy.
Yeah.
I don't know, what do you think?
Well, first, this source needs to come up with something other than sweet nothings. I can't stop talking about that. But other than that, I don't know, it is a weird pairing. I don't necessarily want to see them together, if I'm being honest.
Okay.
However, I would love music from these two together.
Yeah, I think it would sound interesting because Demi's done country before, which I liked. And then John has also done a little country flair.
Yeah.
But he's also doing pop too. So I don't know, I think
and
that could make
recently,
sense.
Recently, since we finally, because think about it, after Demi kind of got out of the Disney phase and she really started to explore and we heard her voice, how it could really be and how powerful it
such
is.
Such a powerhouse.
And then John has that smooth, sultry, laid back voice. I think it would be such a compliment to each other.
Yeah.
All right, and in other news, Justin Bieber is back at it again. Third time, Erin, me and you talking about this this Justin Bieber story.
What is it with you and I and Justin Bieber throwing tantrums?
I don't know, but he threw another tantrum in Manchester on Sunday night. So he's performing in Manchester, England last night, and fans apparently wouldn't stop screaming, which has been the pattern recently because they love him. But this time, instead of, you know, saying that he can go back to singing or doing whatever he's gonna do, he actually dropped the mic and stormed off the stage. And then he said, quote, the screaming during these breaks has gotta stop, please and thank you, and the crowd booed. The audience kept screaming and then this happened. Okay, now when Justin came back, he explained the reason why he came off the stage or stormed off the stage. And then he goes on to say that he wanted to have a connection and he's not trying to be an asshole.
I feel like Justin's on the verge of a breakdown.
Yeah.
Someone needs to cancel the tour. Like he cannot go on like this. I think it's actually hurting his feelings more than it's hurting his audience. Like he really continues to believe that these thousands of people are going to stop screaming for him. I'm sorry, your music is why you're famous, not your beautiful inspirational speeches, which are awesome in a certain kind of environment,
yeah.
Not in a concert. I worry for him.
Yeah, and the thing is, when you go to see one of your absolute favorite artists, because we all know Justin Bieber has these diehard fans, if you go to see him perform, you're going to be excited that Justin Bieber is that close to you.
So, yeah. I'm just gonna sit there silently,
exactly.
Meditate on his beautiful body. I mean, I might do that too, but.
I understand where he's coming from, but at this point, you just have to lower your expectations, Justin. Just know that your fans came to hear you sing. You can, I don't know what's the, Justin.
Do a YouTube channel.
Yeah.
Vlog about your feelings, okay? That's what we do. We get a lot of hate for it on the internet, but that's what we do. Vlog your feelings. Don't get mad at your audience, and don't storm off like a child.
Yeah, well.
Don't like literally drop the mic, really. Come on. Now on to the part of the show that you're most excited for, the nip slips.
Woo!
Yeah, so Britney Spears, our girl, she was performing in Vegas, killing it. She was performing I Love Rock and Roll, and her dancer is seen in this clip trying to reattach her halter top, and the top keeps falling. And Brittany keeps singing, but she can't dance because the dancers there are trying to connect the halter top. She's kind of making weird faces. She's also kind of dancing awkwardly. You could tell that she's just going with it. But I mean, we almost saw the nipple, but I mean, you know, I just love her. I think she just, for someone who's been through so much emotionally, the fact that she can handle something like that, yeah, like a pro, like better than I could handle it, I'm like, yes, girl, you're my queen.
Well, when she's been performing for so many years, she's been doing this show for such a long time now, she's probably excited for a little variety.
Yeah.
Because it's the same thing over and over again. She's probably like, yeah, nip slip, I'm giving you more. Like, just, it needed to happen.
She's like, great, I have 30 seconds of choreography that I don't have to do. Speaking of nip slips, our girl, Megan Ranks, she had a little wardrobe malfunction, bless her heart. She was on the carpet at New York Comic Con with her freakish cast. They all look so cute together, by the way. I'm really excited about this show. It's, yeah, on Hulu. If you haven't seen it yet, you should go watch it. She posted this on Twitter, basically exposing her own nip slip. She had on underwear, but she didn't have on a bra. And under those bright lights and the flashes, you don't realize that something that doesn't seem sheer could be very sheer. So I think it's good press for the show, though, you know? I think every good show deserves a little nip slip in its publicity.
And I like that she took it into her own hands.
Yeah, right? Oh, she, that girl's not ashamed of anything. That's why I love her. All right, and speaking of nip slips, we don't really see one in the Halsey Chainsmokers music video for Closer.
Love that song.
But you guys, someone tweeted at me today to watch this video. I didn't even know it had come out. And I was so hot and bothered watching it. I was like, this is, Halsey is so gorgeous. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm completely straight, but I kind of had like thoughts. I was like, wow, I wonder what it's like to kiss her because she's so beautiful. And this video makes the song even better.
So I know you're excited, Erin. Taylor Swift is back a little bit. So she had a performance in Texas over the weekend.
Yes, she did.
And we found out it's gonna be her only performance of 2016.
What? I didn't find that out. What?
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah, because hopefully that means she's working on more music and there's an album coming soon, but this will be the only performance she'll be doing this year. However,
what?
The highlight of this performance was she did a piano version of This Is What You Came For.
Oh, I saw that clip.
You know? So go ahead and check this out. Baby, this is what you came for. You know, after she had that breakup with Calvin Harris and the drama with This Is What You Came For came out,
yeah,
it's nice to see her perform this song. And she made a joke to the audience saying she wanted to hear the feedback and hear what it feels like to have it sung back to her.
Yeah.
So Taylor's playing around. It was good to see her back in the limelight. But yeah, like I said, there's not going to be any more.
I hope you're wrong because my heart hurts right now because I actually was hoping she'd perform a new song this weekend. She did not. I know today is her 10th anniversary of her, yeah, first album releasing. I'm still holding out hope that there's an album happening today. I can't believe Taylor wasn't prepared for this. She's
what
had
if,
2 years. What?
What if?
What?
She's just tricking us. She comes out, it's like she drops an album, and then she does a surprise performance for the end of the year, just in time for Christmas.
Well, I hope she proves you wrong, for sure. I hope she at least performs one more time, but I don't even care about the performance as long as I get this album.
So after she performed in Texas, she was back in LA to go to Drake's 30th birthday party, and guess who was there?
Drake.
Well, that was a quick one. Drake was
really
there,
on
obviously.
It today.
But her ex, John Mayer, was there.
What?
Yeah.
We have two there. John Mayer mentions in one episode of DHR.
He is truly famous now.
What? Okay, so John Mayer was there. Mm-hmm. Did they interact? Do we know?
They said there wasn't any tension or anything between them. There wasn't any heart feelings or so.
They didn't really interact, basically.
Yeah.
But also Katy Perry was there, I hear, too. Which
he
makes
had multiple exes so, there.
Like, how many people in the room had Taylor Swift written songs about? Was Calvin Harris there? Was
right?
Tom Hiddleston there. Yeah, I think Katie and John were seen, or weren't seen entering or leaving, but Taylor was seen going into the club. Also, apparently, I think Taylor showed up to the party with her squadlings around her, the Haim sisters and Carly Kloss, because, you know, when you're at a party with an ex-boyfriend and an ex-friend of yours, you need to make sure you have some support there.
Yeah.
And Taylor knows how to bring the squad out when she needs it. All right, guys, we need to give Justin Bieber some advice. So leave some advice for Justin in the comments section. How should he handle his concerts moving forward? You think he should cancel his shows? Let me know.
And do you think that Demi and John Mayer are dating?
No.
And if so, do you like it? If not, do you want to get music from them? Let us know below.
Let us know. Also, have you seen our new show yet? It's on Clever TV. It's called That Got Weird.
So good.
And it's so ridiculous and fun. I hope you guys watched it on Friday. It's really good. If you haven't seen it, it lives on the internet forever, so you can go watch it right now. Thank you guys for hanging out. We will see you back here tomorrow.
Bye.
For more, click to the left for an update on Selena's time in rehab.
Or right for Gigi and Kendall's plastic surgery mystery.